This is the simplest Notion inbox you could ever have. Continuing my course on how to build the Notion app system from scratch, I'm going to show you how to make what can be used in any workspace as a very simple inbox. First thing you're going to need is a task database. Now that task database was built in a previous episode, but I am going to show you exactly what makes up the components of it right now. So if we go into this backend task database, we're going to take a look at the properties that come from this task database. So if we open this one, you can see that we have a time here, an assigned to date, and a due date first. Now the due date and the time are different in this sense. Time is when you are going to, in theory, do the task. The due date is when the thing has to be completed or else it is late. And then the tags section here essentially just says whether it's a recurring task, something you have to do ad hoc, something for a project review or for planning. And this is a priority indicator. Now, there are some other ancillary things like files and media, connecting it to the projects database, having a checkbox, and then a created by and a created time function. Very simple and easy thing to set up, but the one thing I would go back to watch the last episode on is how to make a real date. The whole purpose of this is essentially if we have a recurring task, we want to make sure that essentially the real date is factored in. So not necessarily just the date of the created time, which is what you kind of have to default to with recurring tasks and how Notion is currently set up. But instead, if you assign it a date, it would override the created date with the real time that you're inputting here. As sometimes recurring tasks don't get done the exact day they were created. Who would have thought? Thanks, Notion. Anyways, that is essentially what the task database we're working with is. So by going here, copying this table, and going out, and then going to go to this view section. So I'm going to make a new view, and we can actually just duplicate a custom one, do inbox, and call it inbox desktop. You'll see within here, there's some nice navigation bar already put in here. Got a spot to put some different things. Okay, cool. So let's do a little paste function in the bottom section here, just so that we get a broader view of everything. All right, so how would we like to look at this? I think, first of all, hide the database title, then change it to a list layout. Now, I personally think there are a couple ways that work when it comes to, you know, like how do we actually want to think about an inbox? So first of all, I would assume that the assigned to is probably empty. So contains, just kidding, is empty. So if like nobody is assigned to a task in an inbox, whether it be yourself personally or others, and you have an assigned to property, you probably want to have that in your inbox. So I would say that. And then what about a checkbox here? So a checkbox can be indicated as sort of like an archive feature. So you could also have it as, all right, so where the assignee is empty and the checkbox is unchecked as an option. So I would appreciate that. And then also, if I had to guess, that the time would probably be empty, right? Because like you wouldn't have any sort of time that you knew you had to get it done. If it was important and you knew that, it wouldn't be in your inbox, right? So like if it was assigned, that's the whole point. You capture, then you let it out. Now, there's a couple different ways we can look at this. We can be like, okay, what if we want to show all these different properties right here, right? Now, the problem with a list view is that, you know, like you can press edit and then do this. So it's up to you. But if you're going to do it like that, you have to know it's like edit, click in this, assign it to me. Oh, then it's done. All right, but wait a second, it's assigned to me, but it isn't necessarily like, oh, there's no time associated to it. So how should the filter be set up? I was trying to do that for dramatic effect, right? So here, if you assign a time to it, then where's that gonna go? Is it gonna go to my task inbox? Not necessarily. So I'm gonna undo that and make sure we think about this way. Where assignee is empty or time is empty, but then I wanna do and the checkbox is empty. Well, we have to do a turn into group here, do assignee is empty, or time is empty and the checkbox is unchecked. And this basically makes it so that you have to have the assignee and the time both filled in and it not be checked off. So if we check it off, it'll still disappear. Nice archive feature. But you can see these are still assigned to me, but they don't have a date. So like, all right, wait, but when am I gonna get this guy done? I don't know. I'm gonna get it done today. Then boom, it would disappear. So you can either do this in a list view or a table view, and then show those few properties. So let's hide all of them, and then let's show assigned to, time, and a checkbox property. Pro hack, you can take the checkbox property and do this to it. So now we'd see, all right, it's assigned to me. When would I do it? Let's assign it to tomorrow. It would get out of the inbox. It's up to you. Do you want to have it like this list view or this table view? Totally up to you. Now, what I am going to do is actually nestle this guy right in here, and I even like to do this as a view. Like to have it either inside and have this like that, And then maybe move this to the side a bit and showcase just what's needed. Even wrap that column right there. All right, so now we have a pretty solid view. It's an option between these two. And what I do want to do is copy this list right here and paste this. Now, what is the reason for this one? Because this is gonna clearly be an inbox. We can put a little inbox emoji. However, what about this one? This is what I like to call a search module. So the reason for that is because we can do a little search and we can change this filter to search for any of the tasks that exist in our database. So it'd be an inbox for like the inverse, right? So you can, instead of having all this stuff filtered that way, we can do name is, or contain, sorry, XX. So the reason for that is, say I wanted to look for a specific thing that was done. All right, well, let's look for like a task that I did on the actions page. Let's do, record videos. All right, and for some reason in last video, I did not put and checkbox is unchecked in the task section, which is an awful oversight on my part. The reason for what I just did is to showcase that record videos is now not showing on the actions page and it won't show on the inbox. So if we went back here, nestle this guy right here, go to the inbox page, I'm gonna look up, change the filter, record. Awesome, so we can see it's assigned to me, it's done on January 16th and it was checked off. Now you also can have the option to duplicate this, make it a table, show that exact same view. Right? Do you want to see the name like this? Only showcase assigned to time and checkbox. And obviously there is that whole real date situation that we have to factor in. So you could, instead of picking time, pick a real date for all of these from the search side. Do the same thing. Is it going to be January 16th for that one? Well, the real date would obviously show that regardless, but I do think it'd be fair to have it showcase like this. It's completely up to you. Do you want to have it like that view, like this view? Just figured I'd show you both instances of the inbox. And you can just put some random letters and fix this filter. Now, speaking of that whole real date situation, if it's a recurring task, this guy shouldn't be here because we don't really need it to be if it's not time related. Like, we're gonna end up doing the task on the day in our actions page if it's a recurring task and we don't assign a time to it. So what we can do here is add an extra appendage at the end is and tags does not contain recurring. So that guy would sneak out of here and that recurring task wouldn't just show up in our inbox. So we can move this as well to and tags does not contain recurring. That was the simplest inbox in Notion with also being pretty advanced. But we like being advanced so we can teach you a lot about productivity, just like we teach you a lot about productivity in this video right here.